This is the last PowerPoint that covers reproductive system, in this case, female reproductive system. And we're going to close by looking at the hormones of the female reproductive system. The female of hormone, the hormones of the female reproductive system are going to control the reproductive cycles, both the uterine and the ovarian cycle. These hormones are secreted by the anterior pituitary. These are going to be gonadotropic hormones. And these are FSH, which is stimulate follicular development, and LH, which is going to cause ovulation, and it stimulates the corpus luteum into secreting progesterone and estrogen. The cells that are stimulated by FSH are going to be the follicular cells of the follicles, of the ovarian follicles. FSH and LH are also going to stimulate the corpus luteum into secreting estrogen and progesterone. So FSH and LH stimulates the follicles first and then later the corpus luteum into secreting the sex hormones, female sex hormones, estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen stimulates endometrial growth and secretion, so that will be the proliferative phase of the uterine phase. The development and maintenance of secondary female characteristics, which are the growth of breasts, pubic hair, accumulation of fat tissue in the hips and breasts. Estrogen also stimulates the secretion of FSH and LH by the anterior pituitary. However, high levels of estrogen are going to inhibit the hypothalamus, the anterior pituitary, into secreting FSH and LH. Progesterone, on the other hand, is actually the main hormone that stimulates the uterine cycle, so it stimulates endometrial growth, and it's secreted during the proliferative and secretory phases, uterine phases. So going back to these cycles, days 1 through 14 is when the hypothalamus is secreting the gonadotropic releasing hormones that are going to cause the secretion of FSH, which stimulates follicular development. And now the follicular cells will begin to secrete progressively high levels of estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen and progesterone are going to also initiate menses and the beginning of the proliferative phase in response to, again, estrogen and progesterone. This is the development of the follicle phase of the ovarian cycle. So from this diagram, you can see here the follicular phase of the ovarian cycle. So at the very beginning, GnRH is secreted into increasing amounts that causes the secretion of FSH and LH and the development of the follicle. Right at day 14, we're going to have a sudden surge of GnRH, which causes a tremendous surge in LH and FSH. LH is the hormone of ovulation that will cause ovulation to happen. Days 14 through 28, we have the luteal phase, in which now levels of GnRH are going to diminish, and with that, levels of FSH and LH will also diminish. That would prevent a new cycle to start in case pregnancy happens. The corpus luteum is now the one secreting estrogen and progesterone. If the pregnancy doesn't happen, the corpus luteus degenerates into a corpus albicans. The second part of the same diagram looks at the secretion of estrogen and progesterone and the uterine cycle during these phases. So remember that we start the uterine cycle with menses right here, which coincides with the beginning of the follicular phase. We have increasing levels of estrogen and also levels of actually levels of progesterone, and progesterone is increasing very slowly, but not as much comparatively with, to the levels of estrogen, and inhibin is not really being secreted yet. The menses, the menstrual phase of the uterine cycle is replaced by the follicular, by the regenerative phase of the cycle, the proliferative phase of the cycle, in which the stratum functionalis is being rebuilt by the stratum basalis. After ovulation, remember, at ovulation, we have a tremendous estrogen increase, just like a tremendous LH increase. That is going to coincide with an increase in the secretion of inhibin that will stop the secretion of LH and FSH from right here. You have this low secretion of FSH and LH right there. Okay, so after ovulation, that's when we have a tremendous secretion of progesterone. Progesterone is the hormone of pregnancy, and it is going to develop the secretory phase in the uterine cycle in preparation for a pregnancy. At the same time, inhibin is secreted, tremendous amounts of inhibin and high levels of estrogen, which are going to inhibit FSH and LH. So this coincides with a low FSH and LH in preparation for pregnancy. We don't want to start another cycle. If pregnancy doesn't happen, then we go back to menses. Notice basal body temperature can tell us which phase of the cycle the woman is at. So you can see that in the follicular phase, basal body temperature is rather low, and it dips by a couple of degrees right at ovulation, only to increase right after when we are into the luteal phase and the secretory phase in preparation for pregnancy. So keeping track of body temperature, especially with a really good thermometer, can tell a woman what stage in the cycle she's found. And there are birth control methods nowadays that utilize very sensitive thermometers that will track cycles. And there is, it's called the Daisy method, and there's another one, I can't remember the name. But over a period of tracking the cycles over several months, the computer logarithm develops a prediction of at which stage the woman in the cycle is the woman, to based on body temperature, basal body temperature, and prior cycles. And this is a birth control method that doesn't need the use of hormones, because it's just tracking body temperature. Again, day 14 is when ovulation happens. This is due to an increase in levels of FSH and especially LH. LH is the hormone of ovulation. This is initiates the proliferative phase of the uterine cycle. And at the same time, the follicular cells secrete inhibin to stop secretion of FSH and LH and initiate another cycle. So after ovulation, we're going to be in the luteal phase of the ovarian cycle and the secretory phase of the uterine cycle. And notice that at that phase, levels of progesterone, which is the hormone of pregnancy, are very, very high. Days 14 to 28, that's when we are in preparation for fertilization and implantation. Corpus luteus secretes high and high levels of progesterone. Okay, just trying to progesterone stimulates the secretory phase in the uterus. High levels of inhibin are being secreted that shuts down FSH and LH in prevention of another cycle starting in case pregnancy happens. Also, high levels of estrogen and progesterone are going to inhibit FSH and LH secretion. By day 28, if fertilization doesn't occur, menses will start and the corpus luteum degenerates into a corpus albicans. Remember, after days 14 and 28, what's secreting estrogen and progesterone is going to be the corpus luteum. And this is a diagram of the female hormonal cycle. It's a bit more complicated than the male cycle. You can see here secretion of LH and FSH. LH is responsible for follicular development, and the estrogen secretion increases, so progressively higher and higher levels of estrogen are being secreted, which is going to stimulate the uterus into the proliferative phase. LH causes maturation of follicle, causes ovulation, causes the corpus luteum formation, and it is the estrogen and progesterone secretion now after ovulation, and that causes the uterus to go into the secretory phase in preparation for ovulation, for fertilization. Inhibin, the negative feedback loop that shuts down LH and FSH are due to high levels of estrogen and the hormone inhibin secreted by the follicular cells. This is a similar diagram going through the same process. This is after day 10, which we initiate the after day 14, close to ovulation, and after ovulation, we're going to initiate the luteal phase. Remember that estrogen also is responsible for the establishment of female secondary sex characteristics. So you should know the glands that secrete FSH and LH, and what is the function of these hormones in female reproductive system, and what hormones control secretion of FSH and LH. And those will be high levels of estrogen and progesterone and inhibin, which shuts them down, and GnRH stimulates their secretion. What structure secretes estrogen? That's the follicular cells of the follicles, and the effects of estrogen in the ovarian cycle and the uterine cycle. What are the female secondary sex characteristics? And what are the effects of estrogen on FSH and LH? High levels stimulate FSH and LH, but really high levels are going to shut it down. Describe events that happen during day 1 to 14 and later during events 14 to days 14 through 28. Explain the hormones that lead to ovulation. Remember what is inhibin, and follicular cells are the ones that secrete inhibin. And the negative feedback loop that shut down GnRH, FSH, and LH are going to be made by high levels of estrogen and inhibin. We're going to close this chapter by going over the physiology of sexual intercourse and aging in the reproductive system. And similar to the male reproductive system, the first part of the sexual response in females is dictated by the parasympathetic nervous system, which causes an outflow over the pelvic nerves and other organs. It will lead to erections of the penis in males and erection of the clitoris in females, vaginal secretion, and engorgement of the nipples, blood vessels. The next event is dictated by the sympathetic nervous system. That will be the ejaculation in males. And afterwards, detrumescence will be mediated again by the sympathetic nervous system in males. Menopause is the time that ovulation and menstruation ceases in females, typically starts around ages 45 to 55, is accompanied by a decline in estrogen and progesterone. And because there's a decline in estrogen and progesterone, there are no high levels of estrogen to shut down FSH and LH, so the levels of FSH and LH remain high, as are the levels of GnRH. So that's the criteria for menopause is continued high levels of FSH and LH and GnRH. In male, the equivalent is the male climacteric, which is a decline in circulating testosterone while FSH and LH levels rise and a gradual reduction in sexual activity. So you should explain the roles of the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system in intercourse, what is menopause, and what are the hormonal changes during menopause, notably high levels of FSH and LH, while low levels of estrogen and progesterone. You should be able to explain what is the male climacteric and the hormonal changes that take place, which are typically to the one, same to the one as the female, except that now we have low levels of testosterone. Okay, so that concludes the reproductive system PowerPoints recordings.